of the STOLAS Harbormaster Genoa. This is STOLAS' top-of-the-line model of three separate models, the Spinnaker, Genoa, and Genoa. And the Genoa is their most luxury top-of-the-line model that they offer. I will jump right into it here. It's similar to the other videos that we've had featuring the Spinnaker, as it is a limited edition Harbormaster. You see STOLAS limited edition here on the side of the case here. A really nice engraved plaque there. I've heard that not all the watches will have these as they grow and won't have as many limited editions. The crown here is embossed with the STOLAS logo, the S with the lightning bolt on it. It's a really nice crown. It fits in here really nicely with the crown guards here. Fits in there nice and snug. Other parts of the watch, this side is all bare and polished really nicely. The polish on here is really, really high quality. It's a really nice polish. And then the bracelet here has the brush on it as well. The bezel here is a 60 click bezel. And you can spin around, you can see it moving all around with nice ease here. It's a little stiff, but that's good, that way you don't have to bump it or anything. And you don't have to worry about it coming unset. The wave pattern is really cool in here. This is the Harbormaster wave pattern, as you can see here on the logo there. That wave underneath the Harbormaster, and they continued it on with the using the same wave in the bezel for a nice unique look to it. The bezel here is fully lumed. This is one of their patented bezels here. They're the only ones that do the full lumed bezel like this that's not covered by a sapphire. This is orange, and they know the Spinnaker has a blue and the Genoa has a white. That's really cool because when it's at night, the whole thing glows up, and so you're just not having individual indices or numbers or anything glowing. You have the actual full lume of the bezel, as well as the pip here also glows in orange as well. The indices here glow in green. They're a Superluminova C3, and that's why they have a slight greenish hint, because I do have some sunlight here in the office and they are already glowing, and that's why it's showing a little bit of green, as well as a hand. It's pretty neat that the hand is marked with the white green Superluminova to mark all the hour marks, while the minute hand has the orange corresponding to the orange bezel here, so that when you do turn the bezel, which you don't get the minute or the hour hand confused, since the hour hand is done in orange, you know that's the one that you need to pay attention to when it hits the orange bezel, and where the hour corresponds to the hour indices on the dial. So that's really cool. They call it a midnight luminary composite. So it's all hand done in here. There's no machine that can actually put this in the dial, in the bezel like this, so it's all hand loomed by hand to give it a nice finish. The face itself, the dial, is really, really unique to this watch. As you can see, as I'm going to bring it a little closer here, you can see the palm trees and the sailboat, and even if you look really closely, you can actually see the behind the Harbormaster logo, you can see the S lightning bolt logo on the sail on there as well. And you have the nice little orange ring around the date. Really nice dial. I haven't seen a dial like this before, so it's really unique being a boss like that. It really gives a unique look to the watch. Each one of the hour indices are applied. They're applied markers, and they have a really nice blued metal to them as well. So as you rotate this and the sun glances off of them, you can see how blue they are, as well as the hands as well. Hands are also blued metal as well. So that's really cool. As you spin around, you can see how blue, and then sometimes it looks black and blue again. So you've got the applied dials in blue matching the hands. Blue and orange go really nice together, and that's why they use the colors they use with the blue and orange. The numbers are also raised on the dial. You can't see it really in here, but they are raised and they're not straight printed on. There is actually an embossed to them behind it on the dial, and then they're printed on top of that, where the other ones, the carbon fiber dials, are all printed. Let's just jump around the watch here. We got the nice bracelet here. It's polished with the nice satin look. Gives a nice different approach to it, and it looks really good with the watch. These are solid end links here, so they don't fall apart when you're changing them out. They're all solid, and they fit real nice and tight with the case. The clasp is real nice. It has the STOLAS watch logo on it, on the back of the case. It operates really nicely. It's nice and tight. And open like so. It has nice buttons here. The movement you can see here is the Swiss ETA 2024 automatic movement in here. And you can see it has a real nice gold STOLAS logo on the rotor, as well as STOLAS watch printed out on the rotor as well. You can see that in here. Might not be able to see it. Anyway, it's a really nice movement. That's what they chose to be in their all Swiss made model. Other things on here, yeah, basically STOLAS limited. These are only limited to 50, which makes it a really nice limited edition. This one here is 17 to 50. So it's all Swiss made. I know the dial's made in Switzerland. You got the movement in Switzerland. The assembly is all in Switzerland. And you have a lot of Swiss parts. It's a really nice all Swiss made watch. You can hear, see down here, they got the Swiss made on it. Where the other two are not Swiss made, they're actually assembled in the States, but this was actually all done in Switzerland. So it's kind of nice, unique limited edition model. They also come with rubber straps here. You can see here, this is their rubber strap here. Nice polished buckle here. It has their STOLAS logo on it, right there. And it's really nice, flexible rubber strap here. It's really nice and pliable. Anti-static, you don't get have any fuzz on here or anything like that. And it's really neat too, because all the stitching here also matches the watch. Their spinnaker and Genoa is the same, having blue and white stitching. And so the Genoa's main color is orange, so they went with the orange stitching. Anyway, that's a really nice strap there. The other strap you get is the NATO strap, the STOLAS NATO. It was designed specifically for the STOLAS Harbormasters and their color scheme. You got the blue, the orange, the black, corresponding with the Genoa with the orange, blue with the spinnaker, and then the black with the Genoa. And they actually look real nice with all three of the watches. And so the color coordinated for that as well. And of course, on the buckle here in the NATO, it also has engraved the STOLAS logo on that too. So it's a really nice bonus. People who like NATO straps, it's really nice and thick. It's a thick strap here, and it's somewhat pliable. It's not too terribly stiff, but it is a real nice weave pattern on that for people who like to wear these in the summertime, or even diving or water activities. If you don't want to wear the bracelet or the rubber, these are real nice and sweat resistant and so on and so on. So it's really nice to ever get tired of the bracelet to throw this on. It adds a whole lot of color to the watch when you combine everything together. It's just a really nice pattern you have here with all the colors. I have another one here in the office here, a watch I put together for a customer who ordered one of our other straps with it. And I wanted to show you how nice they look with other straps here. This here is the Genoa that I put together for a customer. It's about to go out today, actually. And I fitted it on a orange croc strap. This strap matches the orange and the bezel here and just looks absolutely amazing. I can't really zoom out far enough to show you how well and how good this looks. Basically, it looks, in my opinion, far better than the Omega Planet Ocean with their orange strap. Because it's so much orange here, but it's such a calming design that it's not overpowering in orange. Like a lot of times orange watches are just overpowering, and so bam, in your face. But this is a nice, calm, relaxed look, and the orange is subtle, and they did a really good job of blending it all together with the watch, with the blues and so forth, so that you're not getting just an all solid orange watch and it's just too harsh in the eyes. So this watch looks really good with the orange strap here, and it just looks really amazing the way this turned out. Anyway, that's going out today, along with the nice clasp here. So that's the watch on a leather strap. Really, really nice. The Genoa is very versatile, with, of course, the bracelet, the rubber, and the NATO, and then as well with orange straps. I've seen other people use orange straps on it as well. Some canvas orange straps and so forth, and some orange stitching straps. But this one here looks really good with the orange crocodile. To get back to this one, soon here we're going to turn the lights off here, and we're going to get a loom shot and show you how much this midnight luminaire composite here on the bezel, which is solid, by the way. It won't chip off or anything, and if it gets dirty or anything, you just wash it right off with some soap and water. No problems at all. It's very, very, glows very well. This is probably the nicest glowing watch I've seen. There's quite a few out there that look really bright, but these are really nice. This one doesn't quite glow as much as the Spinnaker and Genoa, because they use a C3 on the bezel for the Genoa, and then the Spinnaker has a different blue loom, which is still a little brighter than the orange. But we will see here in just a moment when I turn the lights off and how bright this can be. So this is what it looks like with the blinds closed. It's not completely dark in here right now, but it does have some sunlight in here, so everything got charged up. We'll take it into some solid darkness here in a little bit, but you can see just by itself what it looks like when you come inside to the house or inside of a building from walking outside in the sun. When it gets a little darker inside, you can see the midnight luminaire composite there glowing along with the 12 dot there, 12 and 6, the hand. Of course, all the C3 markers in the hour hand. Really glows a lot. This is really amazing, but we're going to take it into complete darkness here in a minute and let you see what it looks like. So the glowingness of it, that's a really nice loom job on here. They did a really good job. Really, all in all, the quality of this watch is right on par. The neat thing about this is I would say, I've seen a lot of watches, and I would say this is probably on par with about a $4,000 to $5,000 watch. Being that it's so unique with the bezel, and then with the dial having that nice motif look too, with the embossedness of it, with all the implied markers of being Swiss made, it really puts it up there to a lot of the watches that you normally see in the $3,000 to $5,000 range. This puts it right up there with them, and you really can't see anything different between a lot of like the WCs and other watches out there that are a lot more expensive than this one. The Genoa retails, I think, for $14.99. I think that right now they have a introductory special for $11.99 on this watch. So it is really nice and worth really every penny for STOLAS. It has a really nice lightning bolt second hand there, which I believe is unique to STOLAS. So that really sets it off. It's a big conversation piece to it as well. So anybody who sees a lightning bolt on your watch will ask you, hey, what's that lightning bolt doing on there? Boom, you got a conversation going about your watch. Anyway, this is TikTok, and this is the STOLAS Harbormaster Genoa. I hope you like the review.